something in heart and I want to say it because I think it's the adequate moment. And Daddy is here by me. He will help me in the case I need his help, and I think I will need his help. He talked about Arabic, and it is and it is and it is and it is. And here with us, there is a lot of people. They are not Arab, and they maybe will say, of course he is an Arab. He will speak goodly about his language, his mother tongue. Well, yes, it may look like this, but it is not like this. And I'm giving an example. I gave it in my last class of Muwatta, the last Friday. We talked about Lain, the word Lain, which is the evil eye. In fact, Lain, this word in Arabic has more than 1,000 meanings. 1,000 meanings. That was said, and a huge scholar of Arabic, a Moroccan one, who's called Muhammad bin Tayyib Sharqi. This is the Sheikh of Zabidi, another eminency of Arabic. It's a scholar from Yemen, Tajdaus. 1,000. He said the evil eye. Yes, they call that Lain. The Arabs call that Lain. The eye also, not only the evil one. The eye is Lain. The source of water, Lain. The spy is Lain. The gold and and silver is Lain. The gold only is Lain. The raining days without stop, it's called Lain. I said 1,000. This is one word. In which other language you can find something like this? One word. This is, we call it in Arabic, al-mushtarak lafzi. It means the word in which is associated a lot of meanings. You have the opposite thing. A lot of words mean the same thing. You will ask, why a lot of words for the same thing? It's not, well, when we say the same thing, it's not really the same thing, but there is some nuances. For example, when we say, when you look by this side of the eye, you say ramak. When you look for a very short moment, you say lahadha. When you look, you have absara, you have nadara, you have basura, you have... And this very, very... So, and now we are just talking about words. We are not into phrases, into sentences, just words. And it's just the proper sense. We are not in the, they say, if you get it, we are not in the figurative, we're just in the proper sense. If we are in the figurative one, it's uncountable. And we are still in the words. Now, if you are, if you go into sentences, you are going into something, you know, you see the Atlantic Ocean. It's a very small thing compared to the huge language Jews, which is Arabic. And I will tell you something. I said it's a very attractive subject. Why it is? Because Arabic now is looked to like, let's see, Arabic. It's like something which must be in a museum. It's not something we talk about in sciences. With, no, museum Arabic. And also, someone like me, who speaks, who sings the value of Arabic, must be also here Arabic in the museum. I was one day in Spain, and I was visiting the castle of Hamra. They turned it into Alhambra. They don't know what is Alhambra. We are Arabs and we can say Alhambra. Does not, it's not difficult, alhamdulillah, to us to say Alhambra. So I was in Castle Alhambra. And I was wearing my jilaban to school, and I was wearing also silhab. You know what silhab is? For those who are not Moroccan, the silhab is something which is weird. Over the jilaba? Huh? Because it's the only jilaba is not.